everyone, and welcome to this strength training flow. Today is really not going to be about speed. It is going to be about slowing down, becoming aware of your muscles and really engaging them. So this is in no means going to be an easy practice, maybe for some, but definitely not for all. I really just encourage you to take this time to slow down, become connected with your body, listen to it. How is it feeling through each movement? That is going to be what is top priority in today's flow. So take this at your own speed, pause the video if you need to, but I wanted to just kind of give this intro so that you know what you're in store for, and really just enjoy this practice with every inch of your soul. So with all of that being said, let's get into this strength training yoga flow.
To begin, we are going to start in a child's pose, bringing your knees to the outer edges of your mat. Inhaling in and a big exhale out, repeating this as many times as you would like. Inhale in and exhale out, receiving that positive energy. Coming in now to an upward dog position, looking up to the ceiling and back down to a child's pose. Slowly coming back up, being sure not to strain your lower back too much, and back down into a child's pose. One last time, upward dog, down to a child's pose, and now straightening your legs and doing a slight back bend, keeping your palms together, bringing your forehead down to the ground, arms above your head, and straighten your legs back again, being sure to watch the lower back region. Forward to the mat and forward back down to a neutral position. Going straight into a cat-cow, arching the back and exhaling. Inhaling, looking up to the ceiling and exhaling, arching the back. Come to a neutral position, straightening out your right leg and your left arm, bringing your elbow to your knee now. We're doing a slight crunch, being sure to keep the ab region nice and tight and focused. Never forgetting to breathe and keeping your spine aligned. We're going to repeat the same thing on the other side, being sure that your spine is aligned, keeping focus on your breath, and reaching as far as you can, elbow to knee. Back down to a neutral position, bringing your right leg straight out and your left arm straight out. We're going straight into pulses, being sure to really engage those glute muscles rather than your ab region. We're really trying to work on the glutes in this position. And repeat the same thing for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Good job, you guys. From here, we're going into a puppy position to really open up that chest and stretch out those shoulders. For an added challenge, bring your chin to the mat and look straight forward to the top of your mat. When you're finished with that pose, come straight into a plank, chaturanga tadasana, upward dog, and down to a downward dog. Going into the first downward dog of the day, feel free to cycle out those legs if needed. Do what feels best for your body. Jumping straight up to the front of the mat, halfway lift, forward fold, bringing your whole body down with a slight bend in your knees if needed. Hold that pose, straighten your legs if you can. If not, just stay in that slight bend and breathe. Hands to the ground, coming straight into a warrior three pose. Feel free to keep those arms down on the mat to keep your balance, or come straight into a side angle twist, keeping your leg up in that warrior three position. Switching arms. arms now, this side you may find to be a little bit more challenging when it comes to balance because you're really testing your balance in this pose. Do the best you can, honor where you are always. Coming down straight into a high lunge. Pigeon toeing your back foot into a warrior one position and straight into your warrior two pose. Just breathing, reaching forward and back to a humble warrior position. Looking up to the sky, opening your chest, and always focusing on your breath. Coming straight down into a side angle twist. This is a great chest opener. Looking up to the ceiling. And back into a warrior two, straightening the front leg and going down into a triangle pose. Being sure to keep a slight bend in the front leg if needed. Coming right back down into your plank position, chaturanga, tadasana, upward dog, and exhale into your downward dog. Cycling out the legs again if needed, just really feel this pose out. Jump, hop, or step up to the front of the mat, halfway lift, forward fold. Really sinking deep into that forward fold, always taking this time to breathe. All the way up, rise, inhale and exhale back down to a forward fold. From here, we're going to do the same thing on the opposite leg, right into that warrior three pose, finding your balance and noticing if one side has better balance than the other side, opening up into that side ankle twist. And other side. Just focusing on your breath. If you're wobbly, that is totally normal. Honoring where you are always. Both hands back down to the ground, going straight into that warrior one position. Looking up to the sky, reaching and always breathing. Rotating your arms now into a warrior two, adjusting your leg if needed. Just breathe, reaching forward and back into a humble warrior pose, really feeling that stretch along the side of your obliques. Just breathe. Coming now down to that opening side angle position. Right arm down to the ground, opening up your chest. Back into a warrior two and straightening the front leg in, keeping a slight bend if needed into that triangle pose. Bringing your arms down and stepping both feet to meet each other, chaturanga, tadasana, upward dog and downward dog. Never forgetting to breathe, using this as a break. Bringing your right leg up into a three-legged dog and folding it over, trying to get that heel to touch your glute. Stepping it up in between both hands, finding your balance always. Just breathing. Coming straight into a high lunge position. Adjusting your back leg and going straight into lunges, our favorite. Bringing that knee just to slightly tap the mat for an 8 count. Being sure to keep that front leg in a right angle, not over the toes. Should always be able to see the toes. Now going straight into pulses, a pulse for 8. Don't forget to breathe. Pick a spot to focus on in front of you. Come back down, straightening the front leg and folding over, trying to get that forehead to your knee. Inhaling and exhaling, folding forward over the knee. Just hold it and bring both feet together to the front of the mat. Halfway lift and arms above your head. Big inhale, slight back bend, forward fold down to the mat. Jumping back into a plank, downward dog. We're going to repeat this on the other side. Bring your left leg up into a three-legged dog, opening it up. Really opening those hips, trying to stack them on top of each other. And bring that left leg in between your hands, finding your balance. Straight into a high lunge, keeping that back leg straight, spine aligned. Bringing that back leg now into those lunges. Just ever so slightly tapping the knee to the ground. Don't be aggressive. Keeping that front leg at a 90 degree angle. And always keeping a slight bend, especially when in lunges. Now going straight into the pulses. Ever so slightly tapping it to the ground for an 8 count. Bringing both arms down. Adjusting the back leg and folding over that knee. Trying to get your forehead to touch your knee. And exhaling. Inhale and bring both feet to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Forward fold. Grabbing your toes if needed, ankles, calves. Doing a full reach above your head. Big inhale, bringing the palms together and down into your mountain pose. Now lifting your right knee and hugging it into your chest. Taking two big inhales and exhales. Bring that knee open to the right side of your body. Really opening it up, stretching out that inner thigh and breathing. Bringing it back forward, grabbing your big toe and straightening it out in front of you. If it doesn't go totally straight, that is okay. Honor where you are. Focus on your balance and your breath. For an added challenge, release your hand and let that leg hover. Hold, breathe, be steady, and bring those feet back down to the ground. Big inhale, forward fold, halfway lift, and forward fold. Rolling all the way up vertebrae by vertebrae, mountain pose, and doing the same thing for your left leg. Hugging it into the chest. Opening it out to the left of your body, trying to keep those hips in line with the front of your mat. Coming back forward, reaching for that big toe, straighten out your leg. As you can see, I'm slightly bended as well. Do what works best for you. Always breathing. For that added challenge, if you didn't do it on the other side, let that leg hover. Arms above your head, spine aligned. Breathe, and you're good to bring that foot down to the ground. Big inhale and forward fold. Jumping back straight away into plank. Chaturanga, holding it, hovering. You can do this, you can do this. One, two, and upward dog. sure to inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Now pulsing. So this is going to be a double pulse on each side for 8. 1, 2.
Subscribing to this channel so I can make more and more videos just like this one. If you are feeling drained or tired after this, that is totally normal, especially if you are new to this type of flow. So be sure to get hydrated, do maybe a 5-minute shavasana afterwards and maybe a little meditation just to totally rejuvenate yourself and really take in that beautiful practice that you just had. Thank you so much. Much love and namaste.
She's falling.